Welcome to Nanoka Okure, the very best of Japanese news that's no longer relevant. The Japanese Diet passed a bill last Thursday banning the use of drones near government and other important facilities. Drone pilots can no longer fly their unmanned aircraft near the Prime Minister's office, the Imperial Palace, the Japanese Parliament building, or nuclear power plants. The bill was submitted by both the ruling Liberal Democratic Party and their opposition after a drone carrying a little bit of radioactive material landed on the roof of the Prime Minister's office in April. People caught flying drones in prohibited areas could face a 500,000 yen fine or a year in prison. Wait a minute, if I can't fly a radio-controlled device covered in toxins into the Prime Minister's office, then what's next? Can I not paraglide or hang glide into government buildings either? What's that? Seriously? Well, apparently you can't hang glide near government buildings anymore either. This is a disgrace. The Japanese founding fathers created Japan with the intent that we could freely fly ourselves and our objects in and around government buildings. It's called checks and balances, people. Y'all just think about that a little bit while James gives us the next story.
Japan is well known for its thriving railroad infrastructure. Japanese travel by train more than any other country on earth. Well, one gentleman decided to cut out the middleman and take matters into his own hands. And by middleman, I mean an actual train. The Japan Times reports that a 73-year-old man, Hiromichi Masui, steered his car onto the Hankyu Kyoto Railroad line in Osaka's Yodogawa Ward and drove along the tracks for 6 minutes. A witness claims he saw sparks flying from the man's sedan as he barreled down the railway at 40 kilometers an hour. About 24 miles an hour. He even passed a train running in the opposite direction on the tracks next to him. Police say he continued down the tracks for almost a mile before pulling off at a crossing near Sozenji Station. While no one was hurt, police have arrested Masui on a charge of endangering traffic. He was quoted as saying that he got lost and wasn't sure where he was when he entered the tracks by mistake. Back to you, Michael. Smoke bomb! James out!
Finally, we promise we're not trying to make this the saddest news show ever, but it would be wrong not to pay tribute to Nintendo president Satoru Iwata. Iwata joined HAL Laboratory as a programmer in 1983, where he worked on Balloon Fight, Earthbound, and the Kirby series. He became president of Nintendo in 2002, when Hiroshi Yamauchi stepped down. He saw the company through the turbulent GameCube years. He took Nintendo in a risky direction with the Wii, chasing his vision of video games for everyone, a gamble that paid off with Nintendo's most successful console in years. Iwata is best known for putting himself in the spotlight with Nintendo Direct videos and interviews with staff called Iwata Asks. Unlike his predecessor, Iwata was a game developer and a gamer. He could make business decisions based on his technical prowess and connected with fans on their level. He passed away on July 11th, due to complications with a tumor in his bile duct, one day before he was scheduled to have a surgery for its removal. He was only 55. The outpouring of fan support was immense, and shortly after his death, a rainbow was seen above Nintendo headquarters in Kyoto. So long, Iwata-san. You will be missed. We'll see you next week.